Are you looking for a free or free-ish video editor that's online so you can access it anywhere no matter what computer you're on? Well, this guy did the research.
Right. Came up with some of the best four.
Four.
Headliner, ClipChamp Create, Wave Video, and Adobe Spark.
If you want to know why this guy likes it and why you should consider them, keep watching. I'm Alex with Your Look Studio.
And I'm Evan.
And we are excited to share the research.
That's right.
On using online video editors. Now, why would you use an online editor versus just, hey, let me download a program and have on my computer?
Right. So a lot of these online tools are very much the same. The focus seems to be more on creating simpler videos faster. So a lot of them have social media specific use cases and features and that sort of thing. And they're not as robust as, say, the stuff you download to your hard drive, like Final Cut or Premiere Pro or one of those kind of things. And some of them are geared more towards teams or brands. So if you've got, say, a team of people working in a company that you work with and that you're creating video content on a regular basis, some of these options might be good.
So you can collaborate right. Online. Oh, interesting. Okay. So tell me these four, again, are?
Yes. Headliner, ClipChamp Create, Wave Video, and Adobe Spark.
Starting with Headliner.
It's the first one because it's totally free.
Ooh, I like free.
Yes. We're still not sure why, but they're free.
Yeah, for now. Hopefully it'll stay that way.
So Headliner's really great. I've noticed for creating social content.
Hmm.
So if you're creating square stuff on specific social platforms. You can also, if you upload your own video or if you're working with something in the timeline, it'll automatically generate captions for you.
Ooh, captions are so important these days with social media.
So it saves you the trouble of having to go to some other outside site to get like an SRT file. You can just kind of do it in there. I tried it. Not quite perfect. I didn't have to do a lot of like tweaking, but still, the concept of having to do it all in just one spot was really helpful.
As soon as you're able to bring all the things you need into one place, efficiency goes up.
Oh, yeah.
And that auto captions probably gets you 80-85% there,
yeah.
And then have to fix the rest.
Right.
That's a nice feature, though.
Yes. Something I did really like is that seems like the only place that's offering this are those audio visualization videos.
Oh.
So if you may have seen on social platforms people who upload something like a podcast file, like a clip from their podcast, and it's like a static like photo or something,
and
but there's
like
a little audio visualization graph thing going. So this has a template for creating that kind of automatically. So you just upload your audio file and it'll create the visualization. You can even customize it by color, by what the waves look like.
That's nice.
So if you're creating that kind of content, video-ish content from podcasts, clips and whatnot, this kind of has the solution for you for free.
That is so powerful. We keep seeing that request all the time. It's like, I have this sound bite. I want to put it on Facebook or LinkedIn, and you can't just upload an audio file, make it into a visualization free using this tool. That's pretty cool.
Yeah. So definitely great. Also, like I said, it's free, so definitely worth checking out.
Okay.
Next one from that is called ClipChamp Create. This is a freemium or free-ish, which we'll get into that in a little bit, what that means. This is very simple and easy to use, very similar to iMovie or Final Cut, just in terms of the look with like the dark gray and the purple highlighting colors and stuff. So it's very similar, but everything's pretty much laid out. So if you've never touched an editing platform in your life, you can easily just jump right in and figure stuff out.
So it's pretty intuitive controls. You can pick
very
up
simple.
What things are for.
Yep, and they most of these freemium online editors have access to some sort of stock footage library.
Ah, so you can just immediately pull a quick, I need a file here that I can put text on.
Or music or something like that.
Nice.
Or if you want to create content that's specifically or exclusively stock stuff only with like text overlays and that kind of thing, this is kind of like an easy solution to make that kind of stuff.
Nice.
So you don't have to like jump over to this site and this other site and kind of pull stuff.
Download this file and then upload this file.
Yep.
It all integrates.
Right.
Again, saving you time.
Yes.
If that's the type of video that you want to create.
Right.
Okay.
Simple, very simple stuff. So the kicker here is there was a freemium model. So if you want to try it out, you can do it for free. And the features are very limited. So we're talking like watermark on your video of the company. We're talking like you can only export at really small resolution.
So not that great quality. So if you're using it for business, it's really just to try it out.
Right.
You're not going to stay on that freemium option. But you can test it and explore it.
Yes. So this one starts at $6 a month for a subscription, and it kind of has different tiers depending on what you need. And a lot of them are like this. It's all kind of like feature-based, and it unlocks different features for different tiers. So if you're interested in these kind of tools, it really is just going to depend upon what features you need.
Gotcha.
So if you need access to a lot of stock stuff because you use that kind of stuff on a regular basis, some of the tiers include like unlimited downloads of stock stuff.
Right.
That's kind of like the higher priced one. But if you need that, there's that option. Or if you just want, you know, basic minimal stuff but a higher resolution quality, then there's like a cheaper tier that allows you to do that kind of stuff.
$6.
Yeah.
Roughly.
Roughly, yeah.
Okay. So. Nice. Next option.
Next option is Wave Video. Very similar, another freemium model. Simple to use interface, pretty much breaks it down for you. So if you've never touched a video editing platform or software, this like video editing for dummies, you just jump right in and get to work.
Nice, that's helpful.
Yes. The thing I liked about this is there was a whole kind of tabs across the top of the interface that was social media specific. So if you knew where you wanted your video to live, which platform?
Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram.
Right. And if you want a specific size, like square, vertical, or whatever, you just click one button and kind of format your timeline and your video and everything for you.
Almost sounds like Canva for photos or stuff. You can just
same concept. Yeah.
Okay. But for video. And would it automatically resize and reformat the video? Wow.
I didn't really try it myself, so if you were to do that, you might need to do some tweaking if you have working with a clip or something that's not quite formatted that correctly.
Right.
But the point is that if you're creating content regularly for social media for specific platforms and specific sizes, this is a really easy way to just like one click get what you need.
Nice.
With a lot of other like software specific editors on your hard drive, those kind of tools, you're gonna have to do that manually. So you create a project, you kind of figure out the size and dimensions, and you're gonna have to kind of line everything up. Mm-hmm. So
this saves you a lot of time.
Yes.
If this program just does it for you.
Exactly.
Nice.
So okay, good, something to consider. It seems to be aimed more at brands and small to mid-sized teams.
So okay, how so?
There's a way to like. We're talking about watermarks, but your own watermark. So if you have a brand logo, you can like, kind of add that to their video.
Kind of, you can create it like a brand template. So basically, for your team to be able to quickly create something, and automatically that branded template can come on.
Basically, yeah. Okay. That kind of stuff.
Nice.
So if you're working with a team of people, and maybe you're not the only person doing video, but a couple different people are, then maybe Wave is a better option for you. I noticed ClipChamp Create seemed more like it was aimed at individuals more so than brands. If you're working with a team, then maybe Wave Video might be a better solution.
Gotcha.
And this one, like the other one, is free-ish. And then it starts at $39 a month for a subscription.
$39 a month. So a little bit more than that $6 or whatever. But some nice features for sure.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then we'll close with the last one, which is Adobe Spark. Which is part of their whole Creative Cloud membership thing. So if you have one of those, well, you're technically already paying for it. So
hey, you already have the program.
Exactly.
That's
might as well try it out.
Okay.
Very similar to the other ones. It also has access to stock footage because this is Adobe, so their own Adobe stock is kind of built into that, which was pretty cool. The thing I liked about this was a very interesting way of creating video is it had templates for specific types of video. Mm-hmm. So let's say you wanted to make an educational video, there's an option you could click on, that's what I'm making. And then it would just open up this kind of like almost like a storyboard than timeline, and it would give you suggestions on what to put where.
Gotcha. So it's almost helping guide you through the process of creating the video of that template, and then you just plug in your content throughout it.
So it could save a lot of time if you're making videos like that. You can also do it manually, so it's like you have to follow that template. But I did like the emphasis on storytelling, which is kind of where they start you with. It's kind of what story are you telling? That's kind of how it figures out the template and stuff like that. So if you were trying to create a specific video, like a specific type of video, trying to get a specific message across through that video, then Adobe Spark makes it really easy to kind of walk you through that process and get there and create a final finished video.
Nice. Guided process to the end. Again, the whole purpose of it is trying to speed up, make it more efficient, and get it done faster. Okay. So yeah, I'm definitely sensing the trend here among these four different online video editors. If you need to get it done very quickly and efficiently, and you're probably producing on a regular timeline, and they're not that complex videos, there's a reason to have an online video editor. Or maybe a collaborative workspace to jump on other people, multiple people using this, doesn't matter what computer they're on. There's not just one editing computer that someone has. Access to huge stock footage libraries that you can just immediately pull in. You don't have to buy, download, and then upload or pull in. Yeah. And then also for social media purpose.
Yes, that's probably the biggest one.
Reformatting it to square, vertical, horizontal, whatever those other formats are, into those different places. Immediately all done for you, there's some power behind this.
Yes.
Now, if you want to do more robust things of major effects or keying or other things or multiple, having lots of multi-layer camera or multi-camera shots, this is not your
correct
for you.
You probably want to stick with the big boys, Final Cut, Premiere Pro, that kind of stuff.
Gotcha. But some powerful features in these four online video editors.
Exactly.
Awesome. So if there is an online video editor that you like or have seen that we didn't mention, leave a comment below. Let us know what it is and why you like it so we can look at it too.
Exactly.
Thanks so much, guys, for spending time with us. We'll see you next time.